and a blowing of the breeze. And I was feeling kind of squeamish in the night. I walks around looking at the different styles of trees. I'm measuring their thickness and their height. But there's something mighty suspicious in the looks the darkies give when they pass me and my family on the ground. So it occurs to me that lately, if I can't to try to live, it concerns me for to mince to look around. There's a curious kind of shiver running up and down my back, and I feel my feathers ruffling all the day. My legs commence to tremble every blessed step I take. When I seize the axe, I turn my head away. Folks is gouging me with goodies, and they's treating me with care, and I spat. In spite of all that I can do, I's mistrustful of the kindness that's around me everywhere, for it's just too good and frequent for their trill. Snow's a-falling on the meadows, all around me now is white. But I still keeps on roosting on the ground. Isham comes and feels my breastbone. And he hefted me last night, and he's gone around and grinning ever since. Ain't the snow that makes me shiver, ain't the cold that makes me shake. Ain't the winter time itself that's affecting me. But I think the times are coming that I need to make a break. But it's set with Mr. Possum in this tree. Now when you hear the darkies sing, and the corners all is gay, ain't the time for birds like me to be around. When the hickory chips is flying and the logs been carried away, then it's dangerous to be roosting near the ground. Sing on, Ishan. Grin on, darkies. For I flop my wings and go to the shelter of the very tallest tree. But it's too much close attention, and it's too much falling snow, and it's too nigh.